Francis Udu, Juliet Ezinwamaja Pierce, Damola Adepoju, Olumide Oreshegu, Ibe Ananaba, Emmanuel Stanley Dudu, and Josh Mesironye have painstakingly produced art pieces that everyone can relate to.
The title of this painting is Homeward Journey, painted with acrylic and newsprint. If you look at the paintings, it talks about the hustling and bustling about Lagos, and mostly which are something that will actually be fading out presently because of the new way the government are putting things in place to make it a mega city. And as an artist, one has to really document its past, present, so that we've been able to make a statement for the future people that are coming. This actually captured the scene about Keto Market, whereby we find the strength of women in our society, despite trying to make sense meet and doing some kind of activities. I usually paint life in most of those markets and do some kind of sketches and go to the studio to go and do the finishing. The lot of them do come and find out that these things that you are doing, they'll be looking at it, that someone can have this kind of talent. And they are really impressed with it, that they just tell me, can you draw me also? At least you put me in this part of painting. Even when you see the activities, you see the excitement in their faces, that, ah, this is a man that is drawing, doing so kind of things. And they really give you. And a lot of, like this, even the other painting I did on the Obala in this settings, I did it from the top, very close to the United building. And when I was doing the drawing, some of the commercial drivers that are there just come and look at artists, come and see artists. I like, maybe my son will be an artist one of these days. Part of the experience. And by the time they just look at you and see what you've been able to produce, they are being excited. And that really gives you joy rather than the money that these people are making.
They employed different techniques, each bringing his uniqueness to bear.
The piece is titled The Pledge. The pledge is about dedication. I chose to go for a close-up of a face. If you look at it, it's a bit abstract, with focus being on the eyes. My color palette usually dances between pale colors, but I chose warm colors here to depict the mood. It's a series, part of my go-out stroke acrylic series on cardboard. It's titled Where Are You? Where Are You? Talks about the search. It could be in search of a boyfriend, it could be in search of anything. This, I would say, is a cross in between what I do with watercolor and what I do with palette knife. Like I said, it's an experiment, and I stumbled on it, and I had fun doing it.
I tried to like bring these kind of works to this show as part of the work that I've been doing from the past 6 years. You can see the little girl in the picture depicting a bat. There are so many activities that flows with the water. The bouncing of the lighting, the flows of the water vapors on the body, and the reaction the water takes when it touches skin. End of harvest, as you can see, the background is located in a very dry area, whereby the little girl just coming from the farm with a lot of fruits. And if you look at this scenario, the situation where we are right now, we are towards the end of the year.
Juliet Ezinwamaja Pierce, the only female in the 10-man show, is an advocate for the rights of the girl child.
The bridesmaids' reconciliation led to the new masquerade. With the bridesmaids' reconciliation, which was a sub-theme from the umbrella body I called a large collection of works I produced, which was Peaceful Resolution. I began to create those works when those Chibok girls were first adopted. And one could sense in the polity in Nigeria that a conflict was coming. I hope that Nigerians will begin to embrace new ideas in our forge for the kind of civilization we want.
Dr. Bruce Onobrakpeya, Kolade Oshinowo, and Leko Onobanjo are here as guest artists.
Maybe one of the reasons I have refused to relocate is the fact that I find so much inspiration in the Nigerian environment. These fish hawkers are passed by my house on a daily basis. It's about a young lady who has worked so hard and has put together, the oranges, But then, because of the challenges of life, she fell asleep. Nature calls. And when that happened, there is very little you can do about it.
If you look at that piece there, over there, you see that it's a door. A door that is slightly open, which signifies liberty. And then, of course, the padlock that is open signifies, you know, the opening of a new dawn. You know, so that's also an explanation to what I'm doing now. So if you look at this technique, it's very new. It's different from what I used to do. It's purely experimental.
This is the Hamilton edition of the Content Art Exhibition. The first edition focused on 9 masters.
We had to pick only the big known names to make it attractive for people who are seeing us for the first time. But this time, we decided to pick the next generation still. When they are fresh and young, yes, they might have talent, but if they don't have the discipline to go the long haul, then the artwork you've just bought is just for your personal consumption. It doesn't go anywhere. So we are still trying to look at artists who are more or less established, might not be as well known as the next generation, but at least they've proved to themselves that they are serious about their art.
A 5-man jury selected these 7 contemporary artists.
We are trying to encourage younger ones to get them to have some form of confidence and then, you know, exhibit with the masters.
Both the young and old made our time to come for the opening of this group show.
I'm very, very impressed. I haven't been to an arts exhibition in quite a while, but what I've seen today is just so impressive that Nigerian artists have just gone so far.
Adam and Eve is a one-stop shop for unique pieces for choice homes.
The people who are going to buy from here are not all collectors. There will be people who never thought of themselves as collectors, but because they are seeing it in this environment and they have an eye for beauty anyway, you know, then they will buy the art. So this is like trying to widen the base that the artists would supply to.
The Content Art Exhibition is helping more people become art collectors. This Hamilton edition will run to the end of December 2017.